All right, so yes, as we begin the article, as usual, we have a sentence that tells us our scenario or sets up the scene, tells us what's going on as we begin the dialogue. And that sentence says, Paige is lying in bed, but she can't sleep.
Mm.
I've been there a million times in my life. Thinking about exams is one of those things that would cause you to lie in bed. You're ready to sleep, but you can't.Because your mind is just turning, turning, turning. It's the worst.
It can't turn itself off.
No.
So you're just thinking about all these things.
All your worries.
I know. So what is Paige thinking? Well, she thinks to herself and she says, or she thinks, I got a bad grade on the practice test for the college entrance exam. I can't stop thinking about it.
Ooh, that's a big exam,
That is a huge exam. But she shouldn't stress too much because it was only just a practice test.
That's the point.
Now, what a practice test is, it's not the real test, but it's just a test you take to practice and see how you might do on the real test. But she didn't get a really good grade on it, so she's really worried about that.
That's right. A practice test, it's sometimes also called a mock test. Mock, M-O-C-K, means kind of like fake or not real. It's a practice test or maybe a test from a few years ago that you, you know, do to, just to see how you're doing. And in this case, it is an important test. The college entrance exam is the big exam that kids here in Taiwan and other countries as well will take in their senior year of high school before they go off to university. And it basically says, tells you which university you'll go to, maybe what subjects you'll be allowed to take. It's a lot of pressure. There's a lot riding on it. There's a lot at stake. In Canada, we don't have this kind of thing. We have to pass some basic classes, and then they just look at how good your grades were in all of your classes. But here in Taiwan, I know in Japan and Korea, places like that, the college entrance exam is really, really important. And everyone wants to get a good grade.
That's right. So everyone wants to get a good grade in Taiwan, of course, because you want to get into the school you wanted. Now, grade is our word pair word. It's spelled G-R-A-D-E, grade. A grade is a noun, and we see this all the time when we get our tests back or anything back from our teachers. It's that big number on the top, and it tells you how well you did on the test, or it tells you how well you did in class. Grades can be in a number form, like from 0 to 100, or sometimes it can be graded as A, B, C, and D. And then A's, of course, means that you did maybe 80 and above, B around maybe 80 to 70, and so on. Now let's take a look at our sample sentence. It says, James needs to study hard and get a better grade on his next test. James needs to study hard and get a better grade on his next test.
All right, so when we left Paige there, she was lying in bed worrying about her college entrance exam. She hadn't done well on a practice test, and this is making her nervous. And of course, she can't sleep, so she does something quite smart here. It says, Paige gets up and walks downstairs into the kitchen. Yeah, a lot of people say, if you can't sleep after, you know, half an hour or so, get up, get out of bed, you know, go and sit in the living room, something like that. Just get out of bed, and maybe in a few more minutes you'll be tired. So she decides to go downstairs to the kitchen. And then again, she's thinking to herself, and what does she think this
time? Well, she says, maybe having a glass of milk will help me sleep.
Yeah.
So that's true. If you're having trouble sleeping, sometimes people say drink a warm glass of milk. Maybe it helps you feel sleepier, it makes you feel heavier, and you want to go to sleep. So she's thinking maybe this will help her, you know, get to bed sooner, because it's not nice staying up and thinking about things and not being able to sleep. It's actually quite painful, I think.
Yeah, and then you start worrying not only about your exam or whatever, but then you worry, oh no, I'm going to be so tired tomorrow.
Right.
The day is going to be so hard. So you have worry on top of worry on top of worry. Warm up some milk. I think it does help.
Cookies and milk, I think it could
help. There you go.
All right, so we see our word pair word maybe. It's spelled M-A-Y-B-E, maybe. Maybe here is an adverb, and it's spelled together as one word. Maybe just means possibly, or it's not clearly, or it's not certain, or you're not sure of it. Let's take a look at our sample sentence. It says, Erica isn't at school today. Maybe she is sick. Erica isn't at school today. Maybe she is sick.
All right, so Paige has gone to the kitchen to get some milk for herself, maybe warm it up in the microwave. That's a good idea. So the next thing we see is it says Paige takes some milk out of the fridge. It's a good place to keep your milk.
Yeah, or else it'll go bad. Yes. Now next we see another sentence that describes what happens. It's a scenario and it says Mrs. Wong comes downstairs as well. So her mother is awake.
Oh, okay.
And then Paige says, Hi Mom, did I wake you up?
Oh, okay. Maybe she's a little worried that making noise in the kitchen woke her mom up. But Mrs. Wong, she says, no, I couldn't sleep either. All right. Or I couldn't sleep as well. You know, she sees that Paige is in the kitchen and she's in the kitchen. It's 1:30 in the morning or something like that. So obviously, they're both having trouble sleeping right now.
And then next, we see that they sit down at the table and they're sitting down together. Maybe her mom just also wants to know, you know, what is going on with her. Maybe she can talk to her. So Paige says, I know it was only a practice test, but it still bothers me. Now, when something bothers you, it means that this is on your mind, it kind of annoys you. So she knows it's just a test, but this grade is still stuck in her head and it really, really, it's hard for her to let go.
Yeah, especially right before the real exam. If you do badly on the practice, you're thinking, oh no, the real exam's in a few days. What if I get the same score? But Mrs. Wong is confident that things will be better on the day. She says, I'm sure you'll do well on the real exam. In other words, forget about this. It was just a practice exam. I know you're smart. I know you've been studying. Just try to put that out of your mind. You'll do well on the real exam when it comes up.
That's right. But then Paige still, you know, of course, she kind of doubts herself. She still doesn't know. She's not sure. And she says, I feel so nervous, though. Of course, it's the college entrance exams. It's a really big test. And the questions are very hard. So she feels very nervous about that. Now, nervous here is our word, pair word. It's spelled N-E-R-V-O-U-S. Nervous. Nervous is an adjective, and when you're nervous, it's the feeling of being worried or afraid that something bad might happen. Now, let's take a look at our sample sentence. It says, Mandy felt very nervous before her job interview. Mandy felt very nervous before her job interview.
All right. Well, Mrs. Wong understands her feeling nervous, understands her feeling a little upset. So she tells Paige, that's natural. In other words, that's normal. All right. It's normal to feel that way. But then she encourages her. She says, you should go back to bed. In other words, don't worry about it. Just try to go back to bed. Try to get some sleep. And as she points out very truthfully, you don't want to be tired at school tomorrow. Nobody wants to be tired at school or at work, but it does sometimes happen. Tired is our next word power word. T-I-R-E-D. T-I-R-E-D is how we spell tired. It's an adjective. Let's check it out. Yes, if you are tired, it's basically just a feeling that you need rest, you need sleep. You've been working too hard, playing too long, exercising too much, and your body is saying, stop, I want to lie down, close my eyes, go to sleep, or at least take a rest. If you're feeling tired, yeah, take a break, have a nap, do something like that, and then hopefully in a few minutes or hours, you will feel better and you won't feel tired anymore. For example, we could say William felt really tired when he got home, so he went to bed right away. William felt really tired when he got home, so he went to bed right away. I hope he took his shoes off. So, Mrs. Wong was just encouraging Paige to go to bed because she didn't want to be tired in the morning.
It's terrible feeling tired the next day and not getting enough sleep.
Getting out of bed, making breakfast, and by that time, you want to go back to bed.
Exactly. All right, so what does Paige say? She says, okay, that's true. You really do not want to be tired the next day at school. So we see here another scenario. It's already the next morning. It says, the next morning, Paige is getting ready to leave for school.
Oh, okay, well, let's hope she got a little bit of sleep and she's feeling a little less tired now. But anyways, Mrs. Wong, as she sees Paige heading out the door, Mrs. Wong tells her, here's something to read on the school bus. interesting,、mm-hmm. not the kind of thing you might normally say to someone in the morning as they're going off to school. She said, here is something to read on the school bus. Now, when we say here is something or here are some things, generally the idea is that someone is giving you something, all right? They're trying to put it into your hand. Here's a letter for you. Here's a gift I got you at the store. Here's a bowl of soup for you to eat. They're handing it over. They're giving it some, they're giving something to you in some way.
Mm-hmm, that's right. All right, so I wonder what it is.
It's now, a letter.
Yeah, we see that in the picture. Paige looks at the letter.、
Mm-hmm.
So her mother was giving Paige something, and then Paige says, a letter from Grandma.
Ah,、mm. a letter from Grandma. Mm, didn't Grandma pass away?
Yeah.
Interesting.、Hmm. Now, how is Grandma writing letters? Well,、Ooh. Mrs. Wong explains it was with her other letters. Ah, yes, they found that collection、mm. of some of Grandma's old letters and photos not long ago.
The time capsule?
That's right. Oh, this、okay. must have been in that collection of letters to the family. It was with her other letters, Mrs. Wong says. And then she says, this one is about exams.、
Hmm.
Wow, very interesting. So Grandma kind of knew that in the future the grandkids would be...taking exams, so maybe、
right.
she wanted to pass on some wisdom through the letter. That's、
oh,
very nice.
That's very sweet.、
Yeah.
All right, so next in this scenario, or next in the article, we see that Paige starts to read the letter on the bus.、
Mm-hmm.
So that's really interesting. I wonder what Grandma is trying to tell her, what she's going to say to her about exams.
Hopefully some very encouraging words.
I think it will be.
I hope、
It's、
so.
From Grandma, of course.
True.
All right, so let's take a quick break, and we'll be right back with our review time.